Hey guys, what's going on? Inception here, and welcome to another video. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the new Alessandrini card to review today. So this is the flashback card they released at 1 o'clock. So let's check them out. This is a card I wanted to do on my main accounts because of the first owner concept and because I have a lot of French players in my team that I can kind of work with. You know, if Rabiot in the future ever gets like a really, really cool card, I got some pretty sick concepts to work with, right? So we're taking a look at a card that is 5'8". With high medium work rates, left footed, with 4-star skill moves and a 4-star weak foot. So all of that seems really nice. He does have the outside foot shot trait. He has the injury prone trait and the flare trait. So obviously no finesse shot trait. I was kind of hoping that Alessandrini had the finesse shot trait, to be honest with you guys, because in this game, it's actually very helpful if people are being super defensive and you have a player like this playing off to the right side, kind of going for those things. But the thing is that the chemistry style that we are going to be giving this card hopefully is going to boost his shooting as much as possible, right? So he has 93 acceleration running with 91 sprint speed, so you don't have to improve that, which is awesome. Shooting on the cards at 84 attacking positioning with 81 finishing, 93 shot power, and 89 long shots. So for base card stats, his shooting is actually set up really nicely because of the fact that his shot power is as high as it is, right? Finishing at an 81 with long shots at an 89, while being able to do finesse shots potentially from certain angles will definitely be a very helpful thing to have in general. Base card stats for volleys look pretty good too, so it's not really something that you have to worry about. Passing on this card for base card stats is fantastic as well. Don't have to improve that by giving him an engine chemistry style or anything like that, because the three main dribbling stats that you want to improve on this card is obviously going to be reactions, ball control, and dribbling, because of the fact that his agility and balance are the way that they are. I honestly think that for what you're getting with this card, regardless of whether or not he's amazing or not in game, I think 100k for this card is actually incredibly fair. 90k actually for this card is incredibly fair for what you're actually getting. It's not the league link ups, right? Like obviously the Chinese Super League, you can only work with players like Alex Teixeira, Paulinho and stuff. But if you were to get those cards and you have them in your team and you have that concept going on in your team, kind of cool to work with for sure, right? But he's also French, and French is not a terrible thing to link up with, especially with the players that they release through gameplay objectives and stuff, right? If you continuously play the game. So with this Alessandrini card, base card stats for dribbling are pretty good, but you're improving it even further than what it is right now from base card stats, which is great. His physical stats, he's got 81 stamina with 69 for strength and 86 for aggression. So the aggression with the pace that he has and the dribbling stats that he has is going to be really, really nice. So the way that we're going to be trying out this card in game is in a 4-2-3-1 setup. I kind of want to use him as a cam for now. I do mostly see him being used on the right side, the left side. I see him, this is the type of card for me personally where I see him being used in any of the attacking positions. You could potentially use him as a secondary striker, but he is 5'8", which could affect the card a little bit. That's why you have to have someone next to him who definitely has really, really good attacking presence, right? So we're going to fix this team a little bit here. We're just going to put Rabiot playing the CDM position with Martial up top, and then we're going to have Mollet switched off with Dembele over here. So we can have the left foot on the left side, right foot on the right side. So we're going to be using the 4-2-3-1, but then we're also going to be using the 4-3-1-2. Because I actually like the way that this team moves in general. We're gonna have Matuidi in the middle here. Yeah, so I know how I'm gonna line up with this. So if I can EA, go to my, how do you go to the midfield position? Okay, there you go. So we'll switch him with Mollet over here. And then we'll have Martial playing here with Dembele off to the side and Alessandrini playing through the middle as well. I might put him up top in the striker position to see what's up with this card as well. So let's see. So 4-2-3-1, 4-3-1-2. And yeah, we'll go from there. We'll see how the card plays. I think this guy forgot to put his Mane on left mid, but I think he's using him on base card stats anyways like that. So I think he got Laurent Blanc as a baby card. Yo, no, baby card is the 85, I'm pretty sure.
Is a rivals game to look forward to. I certainly can't wait for this, Lee.
Thank you, Derek. I was just flicking through my notes at this.
That's Mollet making that run. Alessandrini make that pass. First time strike near post. Not good enough in that situation. I think his shot should definitely have been better. It's a first time strike from him as well, so it can be inconsistent. But we move. Little bit of left stick dribbling.
It's there for him.
Keep it in. Nice. So his left stick dribbling is actually pretty decent because of the fact that he's a small player. So it's actually kind of noticeable with this card so far.
Matuidi. Here's Martial.
Okay, so he's super aggressive there. Starts to move into the middle because Martial started to cut back. So his rotation's not bad at all right now. He's rotating with the other attacking players, like how they position themselves. He's going to position himself accordingly, right? You see how he's at the bottom now? He's a player that moves all over the place, eh? Ball roll, go for the finesse maybe? Ah. Try to get that specific angle right there. Didn't really work out though, but... see what he does here. Actually does pretty aggressive run right there, which is nice. I will say, the way that he's behaving right now, he's a player you mostly use in the sides for sure. That's definitely something that you notice right away. Like, he can be used as a cam, right? But look at how aggressive he is, always moving all over the place constantly. Nice little skill move. Actually comes off really fast as well. Ball roll touch. Get on the inside there. Again. Yeah, so his ball roll touches are actually coming off really quickly, too. And that's why that specific thing in this game is so effective. That rainbow flick to get over the defender's head to score those opportunities. Welcome back, baby. Welcome back. Okay, Alessandrini, let's see what you do here. Yeah, so if you play him in the cam position, it's pretty obvious that he moves all over the place. So making the play less predictable, obviously. Responds to your dribbles pretty well, too. Little elastico, little flick, shot. Oof. If it wasn't for that defender taking that little poke right there, I actually may have been able to score that opportunity. His attacking AI needs to be a little bit better right there. So I do those little dribbles to see if he moves into the attacking space quick enough. Players that are really good respond to your dribbles really well in those attacking AI situations. That's not the right pass right there, but... yeah, he's usable in the cam position, but you can definitely tell it's not the position that he himself wants to play in, if that makes any sense, you know? So we're actually going to switch him to the... You can see why Koscielny's not meta player, because pace is lacking in the base card stats. I'm going to try him out in Japes' 4-3-3, actually. I'm kind of curious about that specifically. Alessandrini offering support. Ball roll. Oh, body feint. Shot across goal. Nice little strike, actually. He used manual goalkeeping, and I was still able to score that opportunity with Alessandrini. This is a cool card for 90k. So I think 90k is incredibly fair for what this card offers in-game, for sure. Okay, guys, so the next thing I want to set up with this card, cam position, he plays it perfectly well. It's good to have players like this that always move around constantly. I want to try him out in the right wing position this time. So Matuidi is going to play as my CDM. Martial, I want to play in the midfield because Martial's movement is a little bit suspect. Actually, nah, Mollet actually plays well in that center mid position. I think it's his natural position, actually, if I'm not mistaken. We're going to have cut inside, get in behind for the wingers now. Let's see how this plays.
Determined defending.
Oh, he's aggressive by default. I should have actually made that pass earlier. I mistimed that pass. He made a great run right there. He does have a small little bit of emphasis on his dribbles for sure. It might be because of body type or whatever, but at the same time, gameplay, like, not everyone's perfect at dribbling, right? So it kind of makes sense. Alright, so he's making that aggressive run forward, opening up the space in the middle right here. I want to see how consistent he kind of follows that instruction, actually. That dribbling's actually kind of nice. That situation's great. It's the touch and go movement that I really, really care about.
Matuidi, pure ball control.
First time strike. There you go. That's why it's nice, right? When you have the left-footed player on the right side, while having a four-star weak foot, it's just score opportunities like that consistently. It's really nice. Yeah, this is it's the type of player that you're going to play in most of the attacking positions. Like, obviously, if you use him as a lone striker, he might not necessarily be ideal because of the height that he has. But other than that part of the card, if you want to use him as your cam, your left, your right attacking mid, your... see if I can get Rabiot here. No. If you want to use him as your left, right attacking mid, left wing, right wing, I feel like you can play any of those positions really, really well.
Alessandrini. Onto Molle. Matuidi. An incisive pass.
Oh, nice little first time strike there with Rabiot. By the way, if Rabiot gets an SBC card, hopefully he's actually cheap because he's pretty solid, man. All right, guys, so final verdict on this Alessandrini card is that he's actually really fun to use. So for 88k, it's actually a very fair price for what you're getting in game. For a player that plays in the Chinese Super League, so some cool concept links you can work with there, and also a player that plays for the French national team, so there's a lot of link ups you can work with in regards to using this card in your team, right? So for me personally, I think the marksman chemistry style is the best chemistry style to give him. He is good to use in any of the attacking positions because his attacking AI is pretty decent. I wouldn't say his attacking AI is amazing because even on certain instructions, he doesn't always follow it that well, but at the same time, a player always has their base characteristics that they're going to work off of, and they're going to do certain things based off of other players as well. Like, I had cut inside, get in behind set on him for the right wing position. He didn't always often do it, but that was because of my Molette card playing in that right centerman position, right? And it's on cover wing, so what happens there is that he starts to make that run inside the 18-yard box, so it actually makes your Alessandrini not make that run, but you can see that when that happens, Molette is in the middle, opens up the space for Alessandrini so he can bang that shot in behind the net, right? So it's a pretty cool card. Like I said, I think the price is incredibly fair for what he offers in game. Left-footed players in FIFA are always really fun to use, but the fact that he is a four-star player with great base card stats is awesome. The only thing that's a little bit off is maybe attacking positioning, but that's me stretching it, obviously, because he's pretty good in game. So hopefully you guys enjoy this review. I'll catch you guys for the next one. Peace out, dudes. Love you guys.